50 miles northeast of Portland, Oregon, on the western edge of the Cascade Mountains, rises the icy peak of Mount St. Helens.
The highest peaks of the Cascades are steeply sloped, active volcanoes.
The terrain here is rugged. It's not for the faint of heart.
At 8,300 feet, Mount St. Helens is covered with snow year-round. And around the lava cone is a young glacier, rapidly growing.
How can a glacier that's rapidly growing exist over top of an active volcano?
In 2012, scientists conducting an aerial survey over Mount St. Helens discover an odd-looking feature.
As they approach the glacier that sits on top of the mountain, they see an ominous-looking black object in the ice.
As the scientists get closer, they realize that it's a massive hole, 60 feet wide.
Researchers think it looks like what could be an entrance to a monster's lair, so they dub it the Godzilla Hole.
What is this thing? How and why did this hole form?
Mount St. Helens is the site of the deadliest volcanic eruption in U.S. history. In 1980, after lying dormant for over 100 years, the volcano suddenly erupts, spewing 540 million tons of ash into the air. The explosion triggers a massive landslide, killing 57 people and decimating everything within an 8-mile radius. Could the appearance of the Godzilla Hole mean Mount St. Helens is about to awaken? The crater of Mount St. Helens is so dangerous, it's strictly off limits to the public. Only researchers monitoring for signs of future eruptions are allowed anywhere near it.
The interior of Mount St. Helens crater is a perilous environment. It's prone to rock slides, which sends huge boulders thundering down the crater walls.
Scorching steam is blasting out of the ground, and this glacier is covered in deadly crevasses and unstable ice.
To find out what's going on inside, researchers must descend into the mysterious hole. Despite the incredible danger of entering an active volcano, they make their way from base camp and prepare to descend into the dark, icy cavity.
The hole could be a direct pathway into a thermal vent.
This is a potentially lethal environment. Similar volcanoes emit poisonous gases such as carbon dioxide, hydrogen sulfide, and sulfur dioxide.
They have to be ready for anything and everything.
They have to bring climbing equipment, gas monitors, self-contained breathing apparatus, as well as the necessary scientific and medical equipment.
As scientists ease over the edge of the hole, they rappel 40 feet into its dark passage. Will its icy depths reveal an impending eruption?
Humans have never set foot here before. It's completely uncharted territory.
What they find at the bottom is an eerie, cavernous ice cave. It has 100-foot ceilings, and it's like nothing they've ever seen before. Tall and narrow, the huge ice cavern looks strange and otherworldly.
The heat from the volcano is generating tremendous amounts of steam. Light trickles in from the entrance and illuminates thousands of these scallops on the cave walls. These tiny indentations in the ice.
Beneath the ice is this vast group of towering caves that are absolutely breathtaking. What earthly forces or dynamics could have created something this spectacular?
Seismic readings determine Mount St. Helens is not about to erupt. These glacial volcanic caves are extremely rare and only exist in a few places in the world. Unlike rock cave formations, these caves are constantly shifting and changing as the glacier grows.
Many glaciers around the world are retreating, but this one is actually growing and expanding up to 2 feet per day.
This glacier is only 25 years old, but parts of it are over 600 feet thick and over half a square mile in area.
But is it the heat of the volcano rising through the ice that carves out this giant space?
Maybe the size and shape of each cave can give us some clue as to how these caves were formed.
To probe the mystery of the cave's creation, the researchers decide to construct a 3D map.
The team uses a disto laser to determine the volume of the cave and map its entire 3D structure. So much easier than measuring it all by hand.
They discover a highly unique set of caves. They are able to map out over 7,500 feet of passages and discover 10 distinct caves, some several hundred yards long. But what forces could be creating such an unusual pattern of tunnels beneath the ice?
Normally, meltwater carves out these glacial caves horizontally. But here, we see a vertical cave with dry, rocky ground.
At any moment, hot steam can blast from volcanic vents underneath the rock that this glacier sits on.
The steam in these vents can get to 140 degrees Fahrenheit. If the researchers so much as touch the wrong rock, they could be badly burned.
But rising steam by itself doesn't account for the eerie scalloped patterns.
It's not quite that simple. What could be propelling the steam?
If you stand in this cave, you can feel a surprising amount of air blowing past you.
As snowfall above causes the glacier to grow, underneath, the caves are also expanding. Hot air from the volcanic vents rises and melts the ice. The melting cools the air in the ice cave, which then interacts with the outside airflow, causing it to drop back down, creating winds within the caves that sculpt the walls into strange, mesmerizing formations.
The caves essentially have their own weather systems.
The unique hot and cold dynamics within Mount St. Helens caves are representative of how weather often behaves on Earth. But as experts continue hunting the ice caves for clues to their mysterious existence, they're stunned to discover the uncanny birth of a brand new world.
They discover that when you have all these things coming together, the heat and the ice interacting, something mysterious happens.
Researchers find new signs of life. Mushrooms, moss, and rare microbes are growing in the ice caves.
This cave is incredible. It doesn't just have its own weather system, it has its own ecosystem.
The newly formed caves are filled with volcanic gases. So how is it possible for new life to begin forming in such a hostile and unstable environment?
As harsh of an environment as this is, and given how many toxic aspects are in one place at once, you wouldn't expect anything to thrive here. But life, it finds a way.
So who knows what this place will evolve into? It's so new that we're just beginning to probe its mysteries.
If new life is growing here, inside one of the most paradoxical environments in the world, researchers wonder how long this fragile mystery will last.